Hello everyone. In this lecture, let's generate PWM waves using our Timer 1 module of Atmega 16 microcontroller. Let's get started. So this is the programming part of the lecture, and in the previous lecture we just configured the PWM module for generating 250 kHz PWM wave with 50% duty cycle. So I am copying this configuration code that we did in the last lecture and I am pasting it inside the main. So in this lecture, what we are going to do is we are just going to connect an LED to the PD5 pin, that is the output compare channel A of Atmega 16, and we are just going to vary the brightness of the LED using PWM wave. So for varying the brightness, we are just going to use the duty cycle of the PWM wave. That can be done by varying the values of OC R1A register, that is this one. So I am bringing it here. So if I want a duty cycle of 50%, I can give a value of 512 to this OC R1A register. And if I want a duty cycle of 100%, I can give 1023. So for varying the duty cycle from 0% to 100%, I can give a values of OC R1A from 0 to 1023. So for varying the brightness of the LED connected to PWM pin, what I will do is I will write a loop for varying the duty cycle in the output compare register, that is for I equal to 0, I less than 1024, I plus plus. Inside this, I am giving the value of I to the OC R1A register, and below that I am giving a millisecond delay of 2 milliseconds. And after this loop, I am just waiting here for 2 seconds, and again I am writing another loop, but this loop will run from 1024 to 0 in a descending order. And inside that, we are providing the value of I to OC R1A register, and we are waiting for 2 milliseconds. And after this loop, we are waiting for 2 seconds. So now you can see, initially, when the control comes here, this loop will increment the duty cycle of the PWM wave from 0 to 100%. That is from the value of 0 to 1023. Once the value reaches 1024, this loop will be exited and the control comes here. Here it will wait for 2 seconds, and after 2 seconds, this loop will be running. That is, the value of the duty cycle will be varying from 100% to 0%. That is from the value of 1023 to 0. Once the duty cycle value becomes 0, the control comes here and it will wait for 2 seconds. After 2 seconds, this process continues as this is given inside an infinite loop. So the brightness of the LED will be varied from the minimum to maximum using this loop, and after that it will remain in maximum brightness for 2 seconds. After 2 seconds, the brightness of the LED will be varying from maximum to minimum using this loop. When this loop is exited, the LED will be remaining in off state for 2 seconds. Then again the brightness will be varying from minimum to maximum. So this process continues in the LED connected to PD5, that is the output compare pin of the timer 1 channel A. So that's all about the program. Now I am building the project using the icon provided here. There is some error. Sorry, I left one bracket here. Now I am building the project again. Now the build is succeeded.
For uploading the program onto the microcontroller, Firstly, connect the USB ASP programmer to your PC through USB port. And then connect the JTAG connector from your USB ASP programmer to your development board. If you are not having a development board, or if your development board is not showing this JTAG terminal, you can directly connect the terminals of USB ASP programmer to your microcontroller pin nodes as per this circuit diagram. And you can build this circuit in a breadboard for programming your Atmega 16 microcontroller. After that, power up your development board using external 12 volt 1 amps adapter. Once you have done this, open the program ISP software and choose the microcontroller required in select chip drop down box. Then after that, you just want to check this program flash checkbox and then check this program fuse and verify flash checkbox. And then you just want to set the clock to external crystal oscillator in the fuse bits configuration. Go to the fuse and lock configuration bits tab and here set the clock selection 3, clock selection 2, clock selection 1 and clock selection 0 to be 1. These 4 bits must be 1 for selecting the external crystal oscillator. And now click on this write and you can see the fuse bits will be loaded. Now click on the load flash icon. Go to the respective project folder and inside the debug folder you can find this hex file. Click on it and click on open. Click on this erase to erase the chip and then click on this auto button for uploading the program to the microcontroller. And the programming is successfully done. Now build the circuit to see the output in the hardware. You can see this is the output that I got in my hardware. See you in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.